Hello students, so welcome to modern physics classes. In the modern physics today I will start the quantum mechanics. It's a very interesting and difficult topic. So the classical physics, that is the Newtonian physics, is unable to explain many of the properties, at least even if we consider for the atomic and subatomic systems. Okay, so there is a new theory is developed, that is quantum theory. With the help of this quantum theory, we can understand very clearly. Okay, so it is something called, we can say, Bohr's theory. And already manamu atomic models lo nechukunnam, Bohr's theory, then followed by Sommerfeld theory, then vector atom model. Then we can say these will be the like transitions from classical physics to the quantum physics. So this is the new theory. Obviously, this will be the new theory. When there is a new theory, then obviously ante generally ga manaku edaina oka kottadi oka kotta siddhantam vachindi kotta theory vachindi ante asalu enti dan rules enti dan regulations enti adi ee laws ni follow avutadi what are the principles there what are the postulates there ani antam ante kada so edaina oka theory manaku undi ante then automatically there will be a so some new theory something it is a some new theory so for every new theory there will be some set of rules. Suppose if there is any game, new game is there, there will be some set of rules, or otherwise you can say some set of laws, or set of say you can principles, or say you can say some postulates. So based on these postulates, we can understand the like for example atomic level physics, molecular level physics, even nuclear level physics. And particle physics. Okay, so the finally this theory, that is a quantum theory, can able to answer the unsolved problems that are related to the quantum physics and all those things. Okay, fine. So but obviously a question will arise, so from where these principles or postulates are last came. So you ekkada nunchi vachayi principles or postulates anavante, obviously from experiments. From experiments only these postulates are derived. Postulated ante ippudu manaku oka postulate vachindi oka rule anedi ekkada nunchi vachindi ante so when we observe that physical system observation dwarane ravali ledha let us perform some experiment and conclude something annattu ravali ante so ippudu what is that entire thing ante ee quantum theory ela develop ayindi step by step history anta ayindi అదంతా నేర్చుకోవాలి అంటే ఇన్ హైయర్ స్టడీస్ మనకి ఎంఎస్సీలో సో దేర్ ఈజ్ వన్ కంప్లీట్ కోర్స్ వెన్ యూ ఆఫ్టర్ ఫర్ ద ఎంఎస్సీ ఫిజిక్స్ దేర్ ఈజ్ అ కంప్లీట్లీ యూ విల్ స్టడీ ఇన్ ద 2 semesters క్వాంటమ్ మెకానిక్స్ దేర్ యూ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ అట్లీస్ట్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద క్వాంటమ్ ఫిజిక్స్ బట్ హియర్ వీఆర్ ఇన్ ద బిఎస్సీ లెవెల్ సో ఇన్ ద బిఎస్సీ లెవెల్ వీ కెన్ అట్లీస్ట్ సి అట్లీస్ట్ సమ్ ఐడియా నాట్ ఆఫ్ కంప్లీట్ ఐడియా అస్ అ సమ్ ఐడియా అబౌట్ ద క్వాంటమ్ ఫిజిక్స్ It is simply some idea about the physics, that is about quantum mechanics. So if you want the complete picture, you know, only it will come in the higher studies. Okay, so we will try to understand here, at least I'll try to manage kanisam nenu the theory ki daggaraga mimmalni teeskeltanu ante I'll try to make you to understand what is actually quantum physics. Okay, so finally ga ikkada manam clear ga mention chesam enduku vachindi idi where the what is the necessity of this new quantum theory came. So whenever the Newton physics or old physics, Newton physics we call it the classical physics, so whenever this classical physics is failed, so then there is a necessity of that new theory. That new theory we call it as a quantum theory. So ekkada fail avutunnam ante atomic physics, molecular physics, nuclear and particle physics daggara manam fail avutunnam. Even many things to understand electronic level, then that Newton's laws of motion or classical physics is inappropriate to understand many axioms. So experiment result out ochindadi theoretically ga classical physics is out ostadi rendu coincide kav. So kabatti new theory ochindi, that is a quantum theory. Okay, so ippudu manamu deni start chese mundu manam em nerchukunnam anadani osari revise cheddam. So So it is something like recapitulate and revise what we have learned in the previous classes. The first chapter will be atomic structure, the atomic models. The second one will be matter waves and Heisenberg uncertainty principle. So adi manaku chala important. A matter wave. So matter wave, a chapter lo cheppanu and revise chestanu. Matter wave means a material particle will behave like a wave. Or vice versa, dual nature. Wave will behave like a particle. Okay? So now, so even in a, we can think of like this. Let's say there is an electron is revolving around the nucleus. So this is the electron of mass m and charge of the electron when negative. Let's say it is revolving. We can treat the same thing as, we can treat same thing as a wave. Something like this is the, here electron is a particle of mass m, let's say it is moving with a velocity v. So we can write here there is a wave associated with it, we call as a matter wave. Okay, as a matter wave. So this is the wave concept here. This is completely, electron is a wave here. So electron is a particle here. It will have the linear momentum of the particle. Linear momentum of the particle p is equal to mass into velocity. And here it is, electron is a wave. Electron is a wave. So wavelength will be lambda. Wavelength will be lambda. These two are linked with the de Broglie concept. So that is de Broglie concept. So the de Broglie concept, lambda is equal to h upon p. Then p will be the momentum, mass into velocity. Or otherwise you can write, it will be h divided by, the total energy will be is equal to kinetic energy, that is p square by 2m. Then potential energy will be V. Then this can be written as square root of 2m into A minus V. Okay, fine. So this is the idea that is very important for us. What is the de Broglie concept? Every material particle will have a wave associated with it. It is called as a matter wave. Remember, it is neither a mechanical wave nor an electromagnetic wave. It is a matter wave, that completely new concept. So that means, either we can visualize the system something like electron is a particle, or otherwise we can visualize there is no electron but there is an associated wave called as a matter wave. Either we talk about the lambda, that is wavelength of the wave associated with, or otherwise linear momentum of the particle. So that is called the dual nature, de Broglie concept of dual nature. So another point I suppose to revise here will be the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. So uncertainty principle. Uncertainty principle. What that uncertainty principle will say? If I call two canonically conjugate pairs, let's say Q is one canonically conjugate coordinate, another one will be the their pair coordinates. If suppose I call this is the so position coordinate, and this will be the corresponding momentum coordinate. So according to Heisenberg uncertainty principle, dq and dp will be greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. So if it is a position, then we can write delta x, then corresponding change in the momentum uncertainty is this, remember, greater than h by 4 pi. If there is a y coordinate of the position, then delta py is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Even you can put for the z coordinate also, even you can write for the z coordinate also. So energy and time, there is a relationship. So the energy of the particle is E and the time is delta E, that is greater than or equal to H by 4. So uncertainties, so delta Q is the uncertainty in Q. Delta P, uncertainty in P. I am talking about uncertainties. Okay, so this is uncertainty principle. This is the energy of the particle. This is the time interval. Okay, so these two points are for us important. Even another point I suppose to revise here, this is the transverse waves on a string. I want to revise here for you, that is the transverse waves on a string. I want to revise another point to you, transverse waves on a string. So transverse wave on a string. Transverse waves on a string. Say for example, one end of the string is attached to the rigid wall. This is very familiar to you. There is a string. So when I send a pulse, the pulse will travel like this along the length of the string. I can call the length of the string will be along x-axis. Let's say the vibrations will be along y-axis perpendicular directions. Okay. So now how I'll write the disturbance, whatever it is called, the traveling wave or progressive wave. Progressive or traveling wave equation. Progressive or traveling wave equation will write displacement of the particle as a function of x and t will be is equal to, will write A is the amplitude, that is something like sine of, so something like sine of omega t minus kx will write. Okay, so this is the when even you can write the cos. Some people will write sine and write in the sine. Some people will write cos. Some people will write combination of that. Or we can write displacement of the particle as a function of x and t will be is equal to the amplitude term will be A. Then I'll write e power minus I omega t minus kx. Okay. So omega can be the angular frequency term, that can be written as 2 pi by t, or otherwise 2 pi into nu is the frequency. That is k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. So and also wave velocity v is equal to omega by k, that is even lambda by t. This is the wave velocity, this is the wave speed. Okay, so now when there is a transverse wave on the that we can represent like this, then what is the differential equation of the wave that describes this phenomena? What is the differential equation of the wave? So one dimensional wave equation will be is some d square by dt square, y is the displacement of the particle. That will be is equal to v square wave velocity into d square by dx square displacement of the particle. Here, remember, we already know y is the displacement of the particle as a function of time. So whenever there is a some disturbance in the medium. So here the disturbance will be displacement of the particles. In case of sound waves, we can write the pressure in the medium, density variations in the medium, like that. So here y will be the physical quantity that measures the physical property of the system. So, as it is a physical property, that can be a displacement of the particle, that can be pressure in the medium, that can be electric fields, if that can be magnetic field, that can be anything. So, that way, it can be anything, it can be any physical thing. That can be anything. That's why I write, let us take it will be a psi. Let us write a psi. Suppose if it is, it can be written as xt for 1D. If it is a 3D, psi can be written as x, y, z, t for 3D. Okay, so that's why that can be a displacement, that can be an electric field, that can be pressure variations in the medium. That must represent the physical quantity, that measures the physical property of the system. Okay, so this is the one dimensional. If the same analogy for the 3D, what is the 3D wave equation? Three-dimensional wave equation. Three-dimensional wave equation is del square by del t square. Psi is a function of x, y, z, t. That is equal to v square wave speed into del square by del x square psi plus del square psi by del y square plus del square psi by del z square, assuming the medium is a homogeneous medium. So this is the three-dimensional wave equation we have. This is the three-dimensional wave equation. This is the three-dimensional wave equation, where v is the wave speed. Okay, that is the wave speed. Okay, so fine. So these are important for us to understand what is the quantum physics. See, we are transforming from old physics to new physics. So manaku inta varaku classical physics telusu, dani sambandhinchinave rasam ikkada. Akkada nunchi manam em velthunnam, classical wave equation nunchi quantum wave equation, that is the Schrodinger wave equation ane daniki velthu, okay na. So ivanni manaku avasaram revise chesa. Ippudu manaki quantum physics lo manaku kavalsinatuvanti syllabus enti? So what is the syllabus? సిలబస్ ఏం లేదు, మనకు చాలా సింపుల్ గా ఉంది. సో ద ఫస్ట్ విల్ బి డిరైవ్ టైమ్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ ష్రోడింగర్ వేవ్ ఈక్వేషన్ అండ్ టైమ్ డిపెండెంట్ ష్రోడింగర్ వేవ్ ఈక్వేషన్. టైమ్ డిపెండెంట్ ష్రోడింగర్ వేవ్ ఈక్వేషన్, ద సెకండ్ వన్ విల్ బి టైమ్ independent Schrodinger wave equation. So once we write this wave equations, that is very important for us to understand what is this wave equation. Then we will see the what is the physical meaning of wave function psi, what is the physical interpretation of wave function psi, physical interpretation of wave function psi. Next we'll see the what are the properties of wave function, properties of wave function psi. Okay, next we'll see the eigen functions and eigen values. Eigen functions and eigen values. Then importantly, we'll see the postulates of quantum physics. Postulates of quantum mechanics. So once we have done with the postulates of quantum mechanics, we'll see the one important application will be particle in a one dimensional box of infinite dimensions. Another application will be harmonic oscillator. Okay, these are the things that we'll study here. Okay, so let me revise what we have done here. So we have done here the basic introduction of this quantum theory. So what is the necessity of quantum theory and why it is came, and all those things we have discussed here. So from where the postulates are came from, from the experiments only we got it, from the observations and all those things. So we have revised what is the matter wave. So the particle and wave natures, that is a matter will behave like a wave and wave behave like a matter. and even we have defined there what is the group velocity, group of waves will constitute the particle, okay, and all those things, de Broglie concept. Then uncertainty principle we have revised. Then after that we have seen wave, transverse wave, progressive wave, then we can represent in terms of sine or cos or e power and all those things. Then what is the one dimensional wave equation, even we have written the three dimensional wave equation. That three dimensional wave equation only is required. Then we have seen the syllabus and all those things. Okay, fine. In the syllabus, first we will see the Schrodinger wave equation for a time dependent part and time independent part. Then what is the physical interpretation of the psi, that is given by the Born approximation. Then we have seen the properties of wave function psi. Then eigenvalue problem, mainly these are for us important, that is postulates of the quantum mechanics. Then its applications, particle in a box and a harmonic oscillator problem we have seen. Okay, fine. So thank you. Then we'll go to the next lesson. So we'll stop for the introduction part here. So next class lo manamu time independent Schrodinger wave equation anadi manam derive cheyadam. Okay, then